Everybody, welcome back to SimTech in the G1000 simulator. We're here today to show you how to properly cross-check and verify the points on an approach between the FMS and the FAA approach plates. This is important to do because, especially on a GPS approach, we're following that as our primary guidance to the runway, and we want to discover any issues and discrepancies we might have early on in the flight. Over here on the MFD, we'll push flight plan, bring the flight plan up, and use the FMS scroll knob, pushing for the cursor to scroll down to the approach procedure. And the first thing I'm going to check here is the title. It's the RNAV-19 in Republic, RNAV GPS 19, and that agrees, as you can see flashing there in the FMS, the RNAV GPS 19 in Farmingdale. It says LPV on the MFD here in the flight plan. That's the minimums that we're planning on flying to, so that also checks. Before we start in on this, just a quick disclaimer, there are a few slight discrepancies in the headings between the charted headings and what we have in the FMS database. That is fairly typical of the FMS database. If it's within a couple of degrees, it's considered correct. It's just an artifact of how they figure those headings. We're starting this approach off of Blintz, which is the IAF there, and that's correct. The 343 heading is because FMS is planning to fly that from Farmingdale Airport, which is the final point on our flight plan. So that's fine. I'll just disregard it. And 2,000 feet is the minimum altitude to cross Blintz at. That makes sense. And then going to Derby, 102 heading and 2,000 feet checks to Derby. And Derby at 2,000 or above also checks. And then final approach fix of Maury at 1500 checks as a glide slope altitude, and that heading of 192 agrees with what the final approach course is of 193. Missed approach point's going to be at the runway 19 threshold. 4 miles to get there from the final approach fix checks. And if we go missed, that's going to be a climb runway heading 2,000 feet, then a left turn to 3,000. There it is, direct Deer Park. That all checks. And the hold over Deer Park, 200 inbound course, and 4 mile legs also checks on the FMS, 199, close enough, and 4 mile legs. While we're going through all of the points in such detail, I'll also go through the notes real quick. This is not an approach briefing. We'll cover that in another video. Check that out on our blog at aviator.nyc. But reading through those notes, first one, Barrow VNAV. We don't have Barrow VNAV, so we can skip that. Second note refers to Barrow VNAV as well, which we can skip in a different minimum line. Runway 19 helicopter visibility reduction. We're not in a helicopter. And then when the local altimeter setting is not received, use the ice slope altimeter setting and increase all decision altitudes by 37 feet. So if we didn't have a local altimeter setting, we'd use ISLIP and add 37 feet to our decision altitude, which quick math, adding 40 feet to that would be 388 feet. Go through the same procedure for verifying the points, whether I was using an RNAV or a conventional approach. It's important on an RNAV because our GPS is our primary navigation source, so we want to discover any discrepancies in a low workload phase of flight. If I was flying an ILS or a VOR approach, I'd load that up in the G1000 as well for situational awareness, but I would go through and check all the points just in case there's a discrepancy. I want to discover it in a low workload of phase of flight like this en route rather than in the terminal area while I'm trying to do the approach and trying to figure out, did I tune something up wrong or is the GPS wrong? We hope you learned something from this video. If you did, please like and subscribe.